There was a question by Dr. Naveen Machado. Does methylene blue address cytokine storm, microcoagulation, and viral infection?
See, it prevents the cytokine storm. As I said, that if you, moment you suspect patient is having COVID infection or likely to, means not positive, but moment you suspect, give inhalation of methylene blue, dexamethasone, ipratropium bromide, and salmeterol. It will prevent. My patients, none of them have developed cytokine storm. So that microcoagulation and all the factors, they take just 3 days. 3 days course to respond to 2 days, 48 hours. But 3 days is the maximum they respond and then start improving. It prevents, not only prevent, the cytokine storm is prevented release of, it is inactivated. These interleukins are inactivated. TNF factors and all these liberation of the cytokines, IL-16, IL-18, all these are inactivated by inhalation of the methylene blue. So it prevents, and of course, that's why in the blood also, it will help in preventing the coagulation factor.
So there was a call by Dr. Amit Mahajan from Chalisgaon, who is also an ophthalmologist, who has a relative admitted in an ICU, and he just called me a few minutes before our session started. His question was, the nebulizer that is being used inside the ICU will contain minimum 10 ml of liquid. So whereas the recommended dose was 7 ml for nebulization, can 10 ml liquid be added into the nebulizer?
Yes, no problem. No problem. You can add 10 ml.
Because there's a lot of concern where the dosing has come to, 1.5 ml, 2.5 ml, things like that. That's why.
No. Satish, I'll let me clarify that on behalf of Dr. Golwalkar. See, the upper limit of the dose is 5 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. So that is approximately 300 milligrams. Up to a total of 300 milligram methylene blue, if it goes into the body in 24 hours, we are still safe. Whereas when you give 7 ml of 0.1% solution, you are giving only 7 milligram. If you put 10 ml in that nebulizer, you are going to give 10 milligram. But we are still much lower than the 300 milligram per day. So, I mean, as I said, the first use of methylene blue was 4 gram injection intramuscular on the femur.
No, another way, what I would like to say, even if you give 10 milligram, all that doesn't grow into the lungs. Some get sprayed over the face, some in the posterior pharyngeal wall, and very minor amount it goes into the lung. So that's why I said there's no need to worry, because even if you give 10 ml, 10 ml is not going to enter into your lungs. It will spread on the face, in the buccal cavity, in the trachea, upper respiratory passage, then it will go into the lung. So
Yes, sir. What I mean to say is that even if that entire 10 ml has gone into the body, lung, but in the body, even then, what has gone into the body is 10 milligram.
Yes, it is.
And the upper dose is 2, I mean, the advocated dose by the Mount Sinai Hospital is 2 milligram per kilogram of body weight. So 180 milligram, and the WHO recommends the upper limit is 5 milligram per kg per day. That is 300 milligram. So in any case, whether 7 milligram dose goes into the body or 10 milligram dose goes into the body, it really doesn't make any difference. And even that 2.5 milligram of sublingual dose of Dr. Golwalkar is 25 times more potent than the virucidal dose, as I shown you in the calculation of the molar concentration. 5 micromolar per liter solution can inactivate 6.5 log titer of the virus, that is 99.99995% of the virus. So I mean, even 2.5 ml is a big dose if I calculate that way. I mean, just 2 or 3 drops should be enough to kill all the virus. It's so potent.
Yeah, I have come across many patients.
There was a question.
Yes, Dr. Banugaria.
Regarding the dose, in that era, I have you infused not even calculated dosing, but up to 3 grams.
Right.
In a single patient.
Right. So, right, exactly. So the first use were by John Clark and Mastig, and it's a book, Materia Medica, in which there is a 3-page written on methylene blue, and they mention 4 gram injection intramuscular over the femur, osteosarcoma of the femur. And with 2 injections, the osteosarcoma of the femur started reversing. They treated the patient once in a week intramuscular dose over a period of 3 or 4 weeks, and the patient got cured in 1870. So it was probably the first chemotherapy for cancer, for bone cancer. So once we open the mind on methylene blue and start digging the literature, you find so many references.
That's why I said we have to, it is not the mechanism established as a anti-inflammatory or nitric oxide inhibition and other pathway, but that does not explain the clearance I am getting in tuberculosis in the last 12 years. So there must be some other pathway. I will request to find out, to think in open way, that there is some immunomodulator catalytic effect, beneficial effect, that has to be investigated. This will not explain the interstitial lung disease, what I am treating, fibrotic cases I am treating, but this mode of pathway which is established today doesn't explain the clearance I am getting. There is some other way, pathway.
It is such an unfortunate thing in this COVID business, which is going today world over, where the people have made COVID into a business opportunity. Such a simple thing has not been promoted by any of this government anywhere in the world. It's such an unfortunate, because COVID has become a business for them.
Even the same is true, RC, for ivermectin, as you suggested. Ivermectin is an anti-helminthic drug. I don't think we'll have enough time for covering the remaining topics today. We have to, agenda people, we have to request them to give us another webinar for covering hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide, Dr. Golwalkar, works like methylene blue in the nasal and oral mucosa, and the end product of the hydrogen, it is colorless, and the end product is H2NO2. So it's just simple decomposition of the hydrogen peroxide. And hydrogen peroxide is so potent, second potent after the chlorine, for disinfection of the bacteria, viruses, and the fungi. But since it is not patentable, nobody is interested in that. Same is ivermectin. Ivermectin has such a potent antiviral role that in Australia, they have started using ivermectin, which is an anti-helminthic drug, which has received Nobel Prize in 2015, hydrogen peroxide received Nobel Prize, Dr. William Campbell. So, we are actually, because these things are not patentable, none of the pharma giants are interested. So the Nobel Prizes winner things of past are made to be forgotten. And we are wasting time in trying to find something which is not really working. Remdesivir, for example, works only 8 out of 100 patients. Whereas methylene blue might work 95 out of 100 patients. But under the pressure, the economic drives the medical industry these days. So ivermectin, everybody must read with open mind. I'm very happy to inform or announce that Yogi Adityanath, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, one of the wisest ruler, has found this Australian trial to be extremely useful. The Australian trial done by Dr. Thomas Borody, who is a world famous gastroenterologist, he has found that a combination of ivermectin, zinc, and doxycycline works so well against COVID that in 2 doses of 12 milligram tablet, which does not cost more than 20-30 rupees, the COVID is gone. And they have done a trial in Bangladesh. They have done a trial of more than 6,000 patients in China. And since it has been adopted in more than 32 nations around the world as a prophylaxis for the first line worker, as well as for the prime contacts. The prime contacts means somebody who has COVID in his family, in the blood relation. And in those 32 countries, if you look at the statistics, in those 32 African countries, the COVID is almost nil. In China, the COVID is almost nil. In Bangladesh, it's almost getting cleared. So bypassing the ICMR, bypassing the central government, bypassing the central union health minister, Uttar Pradesh government has implemented use of ivermectin as a prophylaxis and as a treatment. And in my presentation, I have the UP government GR and everything related to ivermectin, but we'll meet again for that. RC.
This ivermectin is manufactured worldwide by one of our Indian company who is supplying the raw material. The name of the company is IOL Chemical. Okay. They are the main supplier from our own country, and we are not able to use
it. Ivermectin was invented in 1974. It completely changed the scenario of African helminthiasis. And the inventor, Dr. William Campbell, and Dr. Satashi Okumura, and Dr. Yu Tu from China, they were given Nobel Prize for ivermectin in 2015. And it's really very interesting to know about that drug. It's so interesting to know about hydrogen peroxide, so interesting to know about how to kill corona in 4 seconds with UVC light, with UVA light, even with the deep blue light. But somehow our government and the agencies, they are looking for something which is not attainable, you know, vaccine. You are wasting so much of efforts and so much of millions and millions of dollars for finding a vaccine or finding an antiviral when you already have at least 6 or 7 weapons which are proven for 140 years.
Ashi wants to say something.
There is one more thing, Dr. Kakadia, we have forgotten, is the ozone treatment, which also works wonders.
Yeah. Ozone therapy works really wonderful. But I couldn't prepare that presentation because for the whole night I was in ICU and I came home around 4:30 in the morning.
Just to remind you the modality which is available.
Right.
The proper presentation next time and come back to you.
Right, definitely.
Kakadia sir, we need to have one session exclusively on UVC and one session exclusively on this methylene blue, because we cannot manage both the things in the time slot that is provided by the companies.
Right.
So,
Satish, one of my friends said that like Murari Bapu needs 7 days to complete the.
Right.
I mean, to complete 9 days to complete the Ramayana. I need 7 webinars, one for UVC, one for UVA, one for blue light, one we completed methylene blue. I need one entire time for hydrogen peroxide, because when I prepare a presentation, I dig from the date when hydrogen peroxide was first synthesized by whom, and then I go through the entire literature and read. So we request Ajanta Pharma to organize one more webinar, or maybe 2 more webinars, one on UVC and UVA, one on hydrogen peroxide, ozone and ivermectin.
There was one important question by an intern, because we have been answering so many questions from the consultants and specialties. So the intern by name Dr. Akshay Patel from Pune, he has got his own doubts. As to melatonin is a hormone which is primarily released by the pineal gland and that regulates the sleep wake cycle. Hello?
See, what about melatonin, I'll just let you know. Around the world, whatever number of doctors have died because of COVID, more than half of them are pediatricians. So then they started analyzing why pediatricians are at the maximum risk of getting COVID. And then they realized that children are the highest carrier of COVID virus. They carry more than 100 times viruses because they keep on playing. They don't believe in social distance. They don't follow social distance. They don't wear masks. And when they come in the clinic, they keep on crying, generating aerosol. And when the mother comes with a kid who has a URI, the doctor has a tendency, torch dalenge or bulwayenge. So when the child is doing to show the UVA, the aerosol is spread onto the pediatrician. So that's why maximum pediatricians died. Then the second analysis came was that why the children are not getting infected, although they are harboring 10 to 100 times more viruses than the adult patient. And then they found this melatonin connection, that because children have very high melatonin, they sleep very sound, very early, they sleep more than 8 to 9 hours. So it's not only that their immunity is strong, but there is a melatonin connection. And melatonin also has been proven to have a good, definitely good role as an antiviral, as an anti-inflammatory, calming down the cytokine storm, and has been shown to have antiviral effect also, to a certain extent. So it's not an exclusive therapy, but it's an adjuvant therapy. But it definitely has a very good role, and there are several papers which have come up on melatonin.
Sir, Dr. Golwalkar, there is another question.
Anybody develop?
Dr. Bhavini Bayani has got a patient with a 22-year-old patient, a lady with the primary pulmonary hypertension, diagnosis last 8 months. Will methylene blue nebulizer help her?
Yes, I have been treating primary pulmonary hypertension, and they are responding because it is antifibrotic activity. They do respond, they are improving. I'm happy with the methylene blue in treating primary pulmonary hypertension. It does help.
Kakadia, can patient develop resistance to methylene blue? After many people use it, can resistance be developed to methylene blue also?
So patient or the organisms, microorganisms?
In general, microorganisms.
No, microorganisms will not develop resistance because methylene blue does not go into the metabolism of the microorganism. Methylene blue actually lyses the cell wall by bombarding the electrons. So it's not actually a drug. It's a chemical. So there is no way a microorganism will be able to mutate and develop a resistance against the methylene blue. At least not in the foreseeable future.
This will help because the strains are changing. If you prepare vaccine for one strain, the strains are changing. So you have to go on finding other vaccine for for that strain. You have to change the vaccine. Instead of that, this methylene blue will act on all the strains. So rather than promoting going after the vaccine, I will advise to go after the methylene blue.
And there are enough number of papers. If you just go to Google and search methylene blue for chikungunya, methylene blue for dengue virus, methylene blue for hepatitis A, B, C, methylene blue for Zika virus, for Nipah virus. Every virus has been studied again, methylene blue, and it is universally viricidal. So, anything which can kill a Plasmodium vivax, which is a fairly large protozoa, if it can kill Plasmodium vivax, there is no reason why it would not kill the virus. The mechanism of action is just bombarding of the hydroxyl ions and electrons. Any role of
Jambu?
No, because methylene blue is the first fully synthesized drug. So we don't know whether Kala Jambu is containing methylene blue or not.
That contains iodine, not methylene blue.
Okay.
It's also staining your tongue, so that thought came in my mind yesterday night. Also staining the tongue.
That is because of the iodine content, not because of methylene blue.
Okay,
you can try to analyze jamun for
maybe we can. Since this has come up, we'll start working on it. We'll get the color jamun analyzed.
No, we do advocate all the thyroid patient to take jamun whenever available.
Okay, fine. Okay. So because of the higher iron content, okay, and that's great to learn from. Very nice, Paul.
Dr. Kakadia, sir.
Ji.
Now so much of information is already been there with the literature and all these things about methylene blue. But why ICMR is still not convinced about the usage, and why it is not recommending to the government of India and in the rest of the states?
Sir, there is something which I cannot tell on the public platform, but me and Dr. RC have a good experience of loggerhead with the ICMR for ultraviolet. not for methylene blue, but for the UVC light when we started working in the end of March. The ICMR clearly said us on phone that we are not interested if it is not vaccine, if it is not antiviral medication. And you would believe, Satish, I am very sure, Satish, once we start creating awareness amongst our own colleagues, eventually a time will come when they will not be able to find medication nor vaccine. They have to start considering these forgotten old gold and golden drugs. So I'm pretty hopeful that by next March, the sense will start prevailing. At least I'm very happy about UP government, because Yogi Adityanath, one of the wisest rulers, has picked up ivermectin trial from China. He tried to learn why and how China killed COVID. See, today we got 78,000 cases in India every day. And China's total is 85,000. They stopped COVID at 85,000. How? So he tried to analyze how, and he found out. And he has started it in UP, officially as a prophylaxis and treatment. So eventually the sense will prevail. We'll keep UVC, Satish. Now we have only 1 minute left. So we will keep UVC as a separate webinar. UVC works very well. Yes, and sir. Dr. Satish has made a very nice UVC coronas device, improved upon the design. And I'm sure Dr. Satish will make a video and put it on YouTube.
Sir, it is the device is ready, but I can share only for a brief period at the end of the session, if you are able to say wind up now.
Yes, yes. I think we are finished with all the questions. And
if Dr. Chotaliya permits me for 2 minutes, we can show a small video on that.
If time permits.
Thank you, sir. So, and I wish from the audience that all the tests have been carried out by Dr. Kakadia and Dr. R C Shah for all the clinical applications that I have shown in the video.
Yes, R C
has something. Yeah. Yeah.
When you use this device now, and when you are keeping it very close to the mouth, you need to titrate the dose, because there are two or three patients which develop a severe ulceration and whitening of the oral cavity. So we need to reduce the dose when you bring it too close. We need to titrate this dose, and not the 4 minutes which we recommended, where it was kept about an inch away from the. So I think all of us will give the feedback so that we can titrate the dose so that we have a minimum.
Those mucosals, of course, those ulcers healed in about 24 hours time.
They got definitely.
But see, what happens is that the UV light's intensity increases by in the proportion of the square of the distance. So as you bring it closer, the intensity increases, so the time has to be decreased. So for something being taken straight into the mouth, maybe 1 minute is more than enough.
Sir, exactly for the same reason, we had to develop a driver. It took nearly about a month's time by the software developers to give us the precise timing.
Right.
So the driver control timer will synchronize with the tube, and we can exactly calculate the dose.
Because it takes only 4 millijoules per centimeter square energy to be deposited to kill 100% of the coronavirus into the cells of the mucosa, or even on the surface of the mucosa, nasal and the oral, and about 80-85% of the viral load is in the nose and the throat. And in 1 or 2 minutes, whatever blood passes in the mucosal capillaries also passes under the UV. So there is a certain amount of disinfection of the blood also. And of course, you are inhaling the ozone which is generated by the UV light. So the ozone goes into the lung and helps to clear the lung viral load to a certain extent. So although it cannot kill all the viruses in blood and lungs, it can reduce the viral load by about 70-80% in the early stage if it is taken. And that is enough, you know, once you reduce the viral load by 50-60% or 70%. Even I have read some papers that if you reduce the viral load by 30%, the body is able to cope with, you know, the immune system will take care of it. It's basically the virus versus the WBC balance, which topples against the patient. So definitely we request Ajanta Pharma to have one more for UV, one more for ivermectin and hydrogen peroxide. Certainly, sir.
Sir, and with your kind permission, I would like to share one more slide of Dr. Saket Patil.
Yes, so yes, Dr. Saket Patil. Yes, he is an ophthalmologist. Dr. Saket Patil, Dr. Golwalkar, you will be happy that with your advice, which we passed to him, and with UVC, Dr. Saket Patil, he got COVID and he came out as a winner. Please, Satish.
So, thanks to Dr. Kakadia, Dr. R.C., Dr. Golwalkar, and Dr. Banugaria, Dr. Satish, for enriching the knowledge and spending your precious time to come over here. And thanks to Mr. Daksesh, Mr. Unarkat, Sarmaji, and entire Ajanta team for arranging such a splendid webinar in present scenario. Last but not least, a big thanks to all the attendees of this webinar, without whose presence it won't have a successful event. So really, it was a great time, and it was my pleasure to be amongst you. So now I hand over to Ajanta people. Sat, last but not least, a big thanks to you too. Okay. Now
thank you all. Thank you. are vacant like they've never been. Everyone's scared of what blows in the wind. The plans we all had have all gone down the drain. Our lives were postponed, but I know in the end we'll be alright. We stand together as one.
The coronavirus is, they don't have a permit.
People need to move into those houses today.
People are lining in grocery stores. Silence is screaming the fear in their hearts. Don't give up your faith, no, don't let your light fade. Together we'll get through the dark of these days. 2 or 3 months, they're saying on TV. Be safe in your shelters and soon we'll be free. One day we'll remember the hardest of times, when distance meant love and it kept us alive. Andrà tutto bene,
tutto bene.
Everything will be alright. Andrà tutto bene, everything will be alright. To doctors and nurses and all those who fight, the heroes that save us by risking their lives. We'll give them our love, yeah, we'll shout to the skies. Brothers and sisters, we're here by your side. Take care of our loved ones, be strong and be brave. Your kindness is something that cannot be paid. And when this is over, the memories will shine of those who passed on and those who stood in line. A few more months, the anchorman said. Divided we fight, but united we stand. One day we'll remember the hardest of times, when distance meant love and it kept us alive. Andrà tutto bene, everything will be alright. Andrà tutto bene, everything will be alright. Andrà tutto bene.